Thanks everyone for joining this discussion. It will be a very informal discussion because I don't have anything prepared. I have this thought in my mind since long back because, it's always that, coder versus designers, developer versus designers. It's like developers are from Mars and designers are from Venus. It's like they are never together, in a cordial relationship. You won't find that. So I'll start off by saying that it's not a, necessary requirement to know code to be a designer. But if you really want to be a great designer, you need to do that. You need to know how your products are built. You need to know which medium you are working on. So I'll start off by saying that I'm a designer. I work at SAP Labs currently. And how about you guys? So how many of you are designers? Wow, cool. And developers? Okay, quite a few of them. And you? Oh, sorry, I should have included that too. So tester is a breed which is, kind of in between designer and developer. I sometimes say that because they do have that, some sort of empathy for the users and kind of an empathy to the technology too. So that's why I, I respect testers a lot in that sense. They are that mixture which people are looking for. Anywho, we'll start off by just, discussing that why do we need to know the design and as a developer, and why do we need to know development as a designer? So if you guys have any thoughts, so you're a designer, right?
Yeah.
So do you code or?
I do basic HTML coding.
Okay.
So I've just done a basic website for some a few companies.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
that's about where it ends. But
yeah. Yeah, that is fine. So in my lifetime, whatever websites I've created are for myself. There's just one I did professionally, and that was for my internship. The rest of the websites I've developed for myself, and they're usually taken from here, taken from there. I'm not really good at coding. In object-oriented programming, I get like 5 out of 10 marks. Really bad at it. Especially in college, you don't realize that you'll require this skill set. So I'll kind of, we will not talk about HTML, CSS because it's very easy to learn. And anyone can, who knows probably, mathematics and English can easily go and do that. So I'll talk about other technologies which are really difficult. So how do I come about this? I come from a design background. I studied design for 3 years and 1 year was common with engineering. So they tried to teach me C++, but I never learned. And the only thing I knew in terms of, if I want to make a prototype, I would either use a Flash, ActionScript, or HTML, JavaScript. So that was my domain. I can prototype my designs, I can do it, that's it. And now enter my life, and I joined Symantec. So it's a technology company, you guys know that, and it's a security company. And I enter there, and everywhere people are talking about servers, databases, this happens, that happens, and I am kind of, and from starting, my design mentors tell me, you don't need to know the technology, you don't need to know how the product works or the feature is supposed to work, you just need to do the design. Probably it was just to, speeden up my process of generating wireframes or something like that. But I kind of believed that, but somehow I wanted to know what are they talking about, how are they making this product that they are going, kind of build it up, and how can I suggest it? Because I have suggested a lot of design improvements and most of them didn't go through. That's what every designer feels. When you propose something, either manager says no, either developer says no. So what are the reasons behind it? I realized I didn't know the product. I didn't know how the technology is made. And for a few months, I was bogged down by this word server. So it seems like, obviously you know what a server is, but it used in so many contexts. I read Wikipedia and still I'm like, why, how can they, kind of talk about everything in servers? And I'm like, and I asked my brother, I can share it with you right now because I don't think you guys will judge me. I can't share it with my technical team over here. That I asked him, what is a server? Why, people keep talking about it? And then he said, seriously? You don't know what a server is and you've been designing for this product? And let me tell you, the product is a market leader with millions of dollars in revenue. And how will you think, they'll accept your designs? I was like, yeah, sorry. I need to learn about it. I started reading about how the product is made. I started interacting with developers more than I would interact with designers. And it was a wonderful experience. I could not write the code, but at least I knew how they made it. I could see into their softwares and could understand the kind of language they were writing. And most of, there were times where I got validity from them and the ideas from developers. So at that time, I realized that, just being a designer and thinking from user's point of view can affect the product a lot, but knowing how it is made and actually conversing with developers can get you a lot more ideas. So, that's how I kind of did in Symantec, and now I'm at SAP Labs. And I had this discussion a few days ago in the same cafeteria where this, idea came up that I should probably do a discussion with a wider group. All the designers were, asking me, why? Why do you want to learn code? We are not required to learn coding. And we are designers, it's not our work. And it's a mind-numbing job. It makes you, because most of them come from technical backgrounds, and it makes you numb. It makes you, sorry to say the word because there are so many developers, but coding is a very disciplined field. And once you start thinking in those restraints, you can't think creatively. That's what some people think. But I tried to explain it using few examples, which I'll share them with you today. And let me, know your views on it. And thankfully, we have few designers who can tell me their point of view. All the designers in my team are like, you're crazy. This is crazy bullshit, seriously. I'll go ahead. So first example I'll take is of architecture. So would you trust an architect who doesn't know, which material to use? So he's making these stairs and, planning these stairs, and he doesn't really know that in this weather, this kind of material won't work. Or there are so many, misdesigned buildings in our country because the architect didn't think through about the climate, about the material. Would you trust an architect? Would that architect ever get a license if if they created a building that is not secure enough, that can fall down at any, in any unnatural scenario? So I don't think anyone will trust that an architect. So it's a prerequisite before you get your license that you work, work in the field, but know how to work in the field. So taking examples from design field, design is divided into various fields. It's industrial design, which talks about your products. So it could include cars, it could include, even the form of your mobile. It's a product design, basically. And then you have graphic design. In graphic design, we'll talk about posters, we'll talk about logos, branding. And then we have interaction design. So interaction design is a really huge field. We can talk about UI design because I think most of us are related with softwares and, that work on computers, mobiles, and such devices. So now think about industrial design. Industrial design is a really very old field. And it was a mandate that if you want to become an industrial designer, you spend some, so many hours in workshop. If there's any mechanical engineer over here, they'll understand how much toil they have to, give up in mechanical workshops. So similarly, my course was like that. It's a diverse course. You learn industrial design, you learn graphic design, you learn interaction design, all basics, nothing specialization. So over there, we were taught to be in the workshops, taught to, work with the machines. So I've even worked on lathe machine, which was so difficult for me to move that I would have to ask for a guy to help me. I know I don't look, like I'm a petite or, who can't handle a machine, but I had to ask someone to come and help me with that huge machine. But I know the intricacies behind it. So if I ever wanted to become an industrial designer after that, I would know, how difficult a welding is and how kind of cuts you can create. So if I ever produce a design which needs to get welding done, I would know. Similarly, with all sorts of materials, we were taught that what kind of material can be used. And it's said that before you break the rules, understand the rules. So this is where, creativity comes from. You understand the rules, how things are done, and then you invent forms in different new materials. So that was industrial design. Now we come to graphic design. So in graphic designs, and earlier it was print design. You would print magazines, you would print big pamphlets, posters. So if you work on Photoshop, any one of you, you know that whatever you design, or Photoshop or anything, if you have ever taken a print, you know that whatever you design, now it actually doesn't come same. It never comes the same. That's true. And I worked in a graphic design firm, and I realized that for every iteration they would do, they would take a colored printout on the material they wanted, and that's prototyping. They are seeing how the colors are coming, how the layout is, how the user can perceive it. So for example, a person is designing a really big hoarding, and in his Photoshop, those fonts look really good, you know, the small fonts. And then suddenly it's printed and it's on the hoarding and people can't read it. That's what I mean, that, you know, you need to understand the, you know, the how end-to-end, the medium that you're working for. And I mean, it's a prerequisite in graphic design and in print design that you know how your end product will look like. However, when we come to this new term called UI design, it's the biggest hype word. It's generating so many jobs right now that you guys will go crazy. Just check out LinkedIn or HasGeek or any other job boards. People are crazy about UI designers. The talent is, you know, less. We are not producing enough designers, as you know, already. And it's kind of it's an influx from, you know, our American and Westernization thinking, that finally people are realizing that to make a good product, you need to have a good experience in it. So we have so many UI designers, and it's such a varied field. People from psychology background, people from development background, people from graphic design. I have seen people working in user experience design. They come from fashion, jewelry design. So there's a course in NID. They're coming from such varied fields. And now they're contributing to this field. But however, they are reluctant to, you know the medium. They are saying, we do not want to know what goes on behind your technical jargon. Yeah, I don't want to know how your architecture is done, why you can't talk to your database for this, and why you can't perform this search in probably required seconds. Why you can't do that, I don't want to know that. I'm proposing you do that. It's possible in Google, it's possible in Facebook. Why are you not doing with this product? I don't think that's a very, kind of a productive thinking. As from designers or from product managers, you need to understand your product. And especially if you're working for an enterprise product, I've spent the last 3 years of my life working for enterprise products, and people tell me they are really, they are sad. They are huge. They have been in the markets for 15 years, and they are the market leaders. The kind of money they spin off, millions of dollars, who earns those, man? So there's this kind of restraint that you need to learn, that you just can't propose, change all the icons, they look pathetic. You know, you are living in some decade-long era, and change all these icons. And probably some managers finally decided that we need to change the overall look and feel. And they spent, 1 year to finally revamp the UI. And there are various other reasons, not just, they don't understand the technology, but something like, recall, recognition, users were used to that UI. And I had this example, the market leader in backup of data. The whole UI was revamped and the functionality suffered. So earlier the UI was really bad, users couldn't understand where they were going, but whatever they did, when they learnt it, was ready for them. They could get the data, they could do their actions, but in this new UI, it just suffered. It would take really long time for them to finally take an action and get the result. So where does it come from? I'm just speculating that people who designed it, people who proposed it, didn't know that the backend architecture doesn't meets the front end flow that you have created. So I believe that if you really want to improve the product, don't just look at painting it at the top. Please look at the backend architecture. What else is possible? There'll be lot many creative ideas inside that too. It's not just if you want to improve the workflow and information architecture, you are anyway going to get it the back. So that was again about software products. So I have this another. So I'll finish up whatever I've already thought to talk about. Then we'll get into a bit of discussions. Otherwise, I'll forget. So has anyone read The Fountainhead? Yeah. Okay. Only one. So Fountainhead is a book by Ayn Rand. There are a lot of controversies. Do you like the character Howard Roark?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Okay. Because I have met a lot of people who hate that character. We are not going to talk about the characterization. Let's talk about what, you know, some of the things that he did. So he, in the book, he is the best architect in US or like in the whatever world. And before joining any architecture firm, he worked as a construction worker. He would lift bricks. He would, you know, do all the things that a construction worker is supposed to do. He knew in and out how a building is raised. And when he proposed a design, it was known that he can himself make it if there are, you know, no workers for him to, you know, kind of get that thing done, or like no civil engineers to help with his vision. So similarly, if you know the medium, and if you, so there's this quote by Jonathan Ivey, the designer of Apple, and everyone talks about him, that unless you know the medium and you play with it, you won't know the limitations and also what else is possible in it. So by medium, at that point in time, he meant industrial design. And in our case, it's the software, it's the technologies that we use. And if we refrain from understanding those, and if we say that it's not our job, okay, you'll be a designer, you can produce good ideas, probably solve a lot, you know, few problems, but if you really want to improve the product and become a great designer, you need to understand how it is made. Otherwise, I don't know, I mean, that's my current thinking. Probably, I don't know, do you think after 5 years I'll say, no, I don't need to learn code? I am a designer. I used to, you know, be averse from technology because I thought, I realized I could not understand the, you know, what else is happening. But slowly, I realized that I cannot keep, you know, shooting in the dark expecting that, you know, things will work out if I don't understand how it is done. There's this another thought that development should also understand how design is done. But now that I understand, okay, I at least understand how the design process is, I need to understand how a development is done. So in fields like web design, graphic design, industrial design, it's a known fact. But for UI designers who are working on really old technology, how does it make sense to understand the technology?
They should understand the technology, but they should not go blinded by
it. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
So, okay, so you don't need to be an expert in it.
Yes.
That's my, but if you are asked, you know, a technical question or, you know, you are supposed to make something, you should know how it can be done. So there are a few examples. So I was making, you guys know infinite scrolling. It's the new UX buzzword. In Facebook, you can keep on scrolling till infinity. In Twitter, you can keep on scrolling. Everywhere, you can keep on scrolling. We were implementing this in an enterprise product where you get, you know, millions of records from the database based on a search query. And the first proposal was to do a pagination, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. It was pretty sad. I mean, why would you want to do that? Can you, you know, because it's, again, you have to look at the use case. If it's a pagination works in some cases, in our case, when the search is done and the user is looking for a particular entry, probably he'll browse through it. For browsing, infinite scrolling works. So this was proposed, and I had a kind of good relationship with developers that were working at that time, and we sat together, and they were writing the algorithm, how the items will be shown. And at that time, I really gained deeper understanding into it. So it's not that they load everything sequentially. Wherever your mouse or, you know, your scroll stops, they'll fetch 500 data above that and 500 items below that. And actually, to, you know, gain understanding into it, I could finally, you know, initially what they were doing, wherever you stop, the data, 500 data or like the items below that will be loaded. It didn't make sense because your half page looked empty. And at that time, because I understood that they can only, they were loading, 1,000, so they can only load 1,000, why don't we do 500 above and 500 below? That would greatly, you know, improve the user experience, and I could give this idea because I knew how they had written their algorithm and they were marking the position in the UI, and then they were loading the data, fetching the data. or else you load the data but start from the middle so that you can go up and go down as you wish. So this is one of the examples where I learned from, kind of, it was back and forth. So developers probably learned a few bits of design, how to improve the experience, because I remember after 3 months, the same guy, he's a really senior guy, he was talking about experience in front of our product managers. He said, see, this improves the user experience a lot. And I was, not a design evangelist myself, but it was really good to see that he was talking about design in that sense. And when I was talking to my managers and I said, see, we did this because, this is the better way and an easier way and more effective way of doing it. Because it's okay, you want to probably propose some design that is that looks fancy on Photoshop, but the response time is really low currently in our product. But if we do, something in a different sense, the response time decreases a lot, and that increases the user experience. So it's back and forth, and that's why I personally believe that you should know, not the details, you can't go to the granular level, even developers can't do that. They won't know what's happening in the different part of the product, won't they, if it's a huge product. But being designers, you need to understand how it actually functions. How is your field in technology moving? How is your medium that you are interacting and trying to mold? So that was, kind of my thinking. So we have few more people joined. I would like to know, how many of you are designers? Sorry. And how many of you are developers? Okay. Nice. And you, sir? In the development? Okay. So we have one tester and lots of designers and developers. So does anyone think that developers don't need to code? Or don't need to, designers don't need to know coding? They should know. See, we are filled with developers. How many of you think that developers don't need to know design? Do you know design? So can you please elaborate a bit on what do you think design is?
So, I think from my experience, I'm right now working at IDEA.
Okay.
Before this, I was working at Intuit.
So I was working at Intuit on application called SnapTax. So it's a mobile tax filing software. So as you can understand, it's more on functionality and less on design, if you would give. But the product manager as well as the UI designer, UX designer, both were very, I would say, over enthusiastic or. I'll just come to that. So there would be these features that would come up, right? And the designer would propose several ways to do that thing. So, and then we would go back, okay, fine, this is good, this is can be done, or this cannot be done, or this will take time. So those are three options that we always give. This can be done, cannot be done, will take time, always. So then the product manager would look back and say, okay, this is a good idea, and though it take time, we'll do it. So the design part was, since it's, see, at the end of the day, tax filing is just entering some fields, right? It's at the end of the day, it's just that. No, even as a user, right? For me also, it's just like entering some data. That's what I need to do. But the problem is, what I need to enter, how do I know that? I think that's where the designer comes in. I mean, if I have to go and group things according to the way the designer came up with and group things along, I would have probably taken a very different path, which would have been really shabby, probably. But
that's where I see, not many problems cropping up. However, if you took an example of Intuit, I'll just mention that Intuit is one of the, design evangelist companies. They are really crazy on design. And they are, even tax filing, because they know it's a very personal thing to do. And if you are talking to end user, a customer that is, you know, like a local person like you and me, and not an administrator, that is for enterprise applications, they take into account that his experience is, you know, does matters, or kind of is good enough to come back to that product. Yeah, Intuit is a really, I mean, if you any designers want to join, I'll say Intuit is really good. They have some design direction. They have a really big graph. Sometime back, I saw that. Just telling, you know, how the I don't know how the relation between design and development is. In Symantec, it's not too good. At SAP Labs, it's still, there are these rifts that you find between designers and development. And we'll take examples from the best of the lot. So I'm following this question on Quora, which says that should interaction designers know how to build the products they're designing for? And over there, yeah? Interaction design is like UI design. Sorry. I'll have to explain. No, UX, UI, and interaction are completely different. Do you really want to get into that? We can. Later. Fine. So you keep using these words because in Google they call themselves interaction designers. Over here we call ourselves user experience designers. These are the fancy terms that we give ourselves. It depends, you know, what we really want to do. It doesn't matter, like the kind of work we get to do is slightly different. However, there was an answer from an employee from Google he said, absolutely, I know how to, you know, design whatever I'm how to develop whatever I'm proposing, but at the same time I have really enthusiastic and really good developers who help me in achieving that vision. And it's so I realized that Google is not a design driven company. However, they have that kind of a combination between design and development. So whenever you look at their profile, the designers at Google are doing all sorts of things. They are doing HTML, they are doing CSS, they are probably doing backend too. I don't know, but they know. And if you ever apply to such companies as a designer, they'll ask you, do you know technology? Because you are working in technology and you are going to be designing for, you know, future technology or, you know, current technology, you should have an idea at least how it is, you know, shaping up. So you can't just say that I'll sit in my, kind of my own area and won't talk about technology because it doesn't bother me. It's probably because when you come from a technical field, you get, you know, too bogged down by technology and then you can't think of creative ideas, as you so put it. So you have to be, you know, be wary of that too, that you don't get too much into technical details, start coding on yourself, that you can't actually solve problems for which designers are there. So again, it's a, you know, cat and mouse situation. You want to, you know, do this too, but not get too bogged down by it. So does anyone else have an opinion of what they think design is? I know it's a very basic question. We come back to it every time. But I would like to know from a, you know, developer point of view as to what do they think design is and do they think it adds value to their work. Do you want to share something? So, I've read a blog post. Sorry, I stalk people. I know what they are doing, at least in, you know, career-wise. So, she is a developer turned getting into design, right? You're not learning design. Somehow, I saw some post related to design. Anyway, we would like to know what do you think of design as a field. Cool, man. Sorry. So, you are a designer. So, but you are working for web currently.
Well, I do content marketing.
Content marketing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I'm in the marketing industry. But I also am asked to, like, do UI design.
Okay.
Yeah. I work in a startup. So
yeah.
I can go to the other sessions.
Yeah, startups have a very different culture. When you compare startups and corporates, you'll realize that there's this overall perception in our design community For me, it's like startup designers are much more capable and much more efficient. They know a lot better than corporate designers. Why is that case? Because I would say that startup designers are grilled to their core. They are made to do everything. Oh, you are a designer? Come, we need a logo get done. Because I have worked for a few startups for my friends. Nothing, kind of full time. Logo bhi aata hai. Do the logo. You know website design? Okay. You have designed? Now develop it. Oh, fine, you have developed the HTML. Oh, now put up the SQL and, why don't you do it in a content management system? We want it up and, okay, that is done. Oh, you know social networking too? Why don't you do the marketing too for us or like a publicity to us? And they end up learning a lot as compared to corporate designers. Corporate designers are like, okay, we have a really highly skilled team to do development, to do testing, to do probably everything. We have visual designers, we have researchers. So interaction designer will only focus on workflows, UIs, and user experience. And if you are only doing just that, probably you can expand your views and try to learn other things too. And oh man, I've heard that. So I know someone who used to work at Samsung, and the biggest line she heard was every day probably, "Acha, you are designing this? Copy from Apple." Don't quote it anywhere. But
it's
this.
Quoted.
Sorry.
It's already quoted.
Oh, sorry. It's okay. I didn't mention the name though. But in my career, I haven't heard that copy from this product, because the products that I was involved in were like unique, one of a kind. You won't find them anywhere. And people who have been using it are using it because they couldn't find anything else. Seriously, that is the power of technology. People are using really badly designed products because they don't have anything else. So currently, what happens, there are competition rising, and there are a lot many startups coming up with good technologies that can give competition. At that time, they'll think of improving the user experience of those products. That is why, we get hired in such companies where user experience is not given that much importance earlier, but now it's shaping up. Because people are realizing that you need to give your users, the ease, the simplicity, and the pleasure in using your product. As otherwise, they'll move on to your competition. So. So I've been asked these questions a lot of time, that how to know design. So the thing is that if you read any theoretical book, they'll be really boring. But read. Okay. Read Design of Everyday Things. You have read that? Huh? Sorry? Design of Everyday Things. Yes. Donald Norman. Don't make me think.
Victor Pepenick, Design for the Real World.
No, I haven't read that. Is it a good book?
Yeah. I mean, I haven't read that. I started it, but.
So, Design of Everyday Things is a really good book because it's a conversational book. It doesn't bog you down with, this you need to do, grid, layout, structure, software, nothing. It talks about simple things that are there in your life, and when you read them, you'll realize how much you prefer good design over bad design. It's human tendency. You don't even know that you are doing it. Another book is Emotional Design. And earlier it was said that products that we use are, they should have good usability, that's it. We don't care how they look, because, look and feel, okay, it's fine. But usability should be the utmost importance, that they can do the task, the functionality is good. But that was a very, kind of 90s thinking. Then came emotional design, which says that even if your product doesn't work as well, but it provides a good experience, people would use it. Was the shocking thinking to me, because I was pro usability. Only usability matters. I don't care that you want to make it look fancy, because what is fancy today won't be fancy 10 years down the line. But then I realized after reading this book, Emotional Design, that experience matters. Why? because I have seen people, and in experience you can include anything. Like I just talked about, people are using a product that solves their purpose, that backs up thousands of their servers, because no other product can do that. But it's a really bad UI. It takes them 2 days to complete that action, but they still do it, because at the end, their work gets done. Their experience is of fulfillment. So experience does matter in cases like this. So UI versus UX, I think I told you a bit of difference here. UI was bad, but UX was good. UI is those controls that you see and you kind of interact with that. That's the interface, and experience covers everything. Every touch point, it even covers when you call for support. See, my, you know, this thing is not working. How do I get support for that? How do I get help for that? Do I click on documentation? Do I call the support team? Do I talk to them? Do I chat over them? That completes everything. Interaction design is slightly a bigger, it's even bigger than user experience. So it will be slightly difficult for me to explain right now. So I guess, I wanted to be a, you know, kind of a back and forth discussion so that we can, you know, gain some ideas. And whenever I've talked about this, I have either faced, you know, a lot of criticism from designers or approval from developers. They say, yes, you need to know the development, because with the, you know, swift of your line in Photoshop, you create like 1,000 lines of codes for us. You don't know what you are doing. You just create the design and it increases our work. You need to know, end of coding. But, does it really help to understand it? And because sometimes people will ask you to code. Is it the work of designers to code? Do you think so? Okay, prototype. He says no. Do you guys think that designers should code?
Okay, so actually you have to draw a line.
Yeah.
Coding for the engines that the browsers use, like V8 engine, Chrome uses.
That.
I don't go into that. I don't go into machine language.
Okay.
Yeah, there is a line you have to draw. You have to see. Okay, I don't want to cross this line. That you have to do.
So do you guys think it will be better that if the designers, whatever he has created, codes it? That's what happens in startups. They are made to write everything. They are made to do everything. They should know, but they should not. I mean, they should know how it is done. They should learn the technology, but they should not be required to do. What are the reasons? First, I'll tell you, if a guy is good in designing, I'm telling you, it will. You know, the code won't be good in quality as much as the design. So it's like to each his own. Why would you want to? Do they, like he explains, there are categories. You do this work, the other guy does the other work, and probably that's why. But I know people who would say that why don't you go and develop this? Why don't you write this code? And because you go there and say, they tell you, see, we can't do aligning. Nahi ho raha hai. I've heard this so many times. It's not aligning. We have tried aligning in our CSS and HTML. It's not aligning at all. Now you go there. And the biggest part and, kind of highlight came to me when the developer told me that she can't align these two buttons. And I went there, align? Can't align? What's, I mean, but the thing was that probably she's a back-end developer, and now she was working on front-end. And again, I mean, she's also learning this, and I was there, and we sat on it for half an hour. Seriously, it takes that much time if you want to reach perfection, because there were one pixel. Yeah, sometimes it happens, but yeah, she spent a lot of time and said that we can't do the alignment. We sat there for half an hour, and because I was not afraid of, HTML never actually feared me, but I was not afraid of sitting down and helping and, kind of doing the brainstorming together, because it's our product at the end of the day. So we sat together, aligned the item, and it was done. So that is one of the points. You can talk to them on the same level. So this is the thinking when I say that designers should know development and developers should know design. It's because you can talk on the same level. So when you talk to designers, you can talk about anything, Gestalt, and this circle is the new thing that is in, and you can talk about different layouts. Or you can talk in a very gibberish thing which you, I mean, probably a person from a different field will find very difficult to understand. Similar is with developers. You sit in those meetings and it goes on and on. They are talking about, we wrote this query, but it didn't hit the database because somehow we didn't refine the metadata properly. And what is happening? But if I knew these keywords, that's how I have learned. I've learned these keywords, and I can fit into any discussions developers are having and sometimes give inputs and be at the same level. So it's really good when developers also know a bit about design, when they talk about users and they're trying to improve the experience of the users, or when I talk about from the product side that probably we can change this layer and improve it, you know, to get a better response time. So something where you can talk on a similar level is required. And soon in future, hopefully we'll see a breed where design and development meets and people, you know, kind of, it's not as distinct as it is right now. You dabble into both the fields. I think my time is over or not? Almost? It's lunchtime? Okay. So let's go eat. I'll eat SAP's lunch even on weekend. Cool. Any questions? Sorry, I forgot to say ask that. I sit through boring meetings and keep my eyes open. Seriously. And no, because it's even boring for the developers. I've seen developers dozing off in those meetings, and they're like, what are these architects discussing? What is the product management saying? We don't know. Let's do some Facebooking. I sit through those meetings and I listen to each and everything, and then I take those keywords in, then I go search Wikipedia. Seriously, it's as simple as that.
So what about, you know, when you are a designer?
Yeah. Do it.
No, seriously. What level?
Again, it depends. Do you want to switch to design? No. Just want to know what design is, design thinking?
Same thing as me.
Yeah. Same thing as me. So, yeah, I'm trying to figure out. So, why don't, when designers start explaining why they made a certain workflow, start, you know, kind of asking them questions like, why do you think it will help the user? What is, the reasoning behind your proposing this UI? They will have the answers. If they don't have, ask them to go back and search for it. Or something like your product is getting tested, be a part of it. So when you see user, I mean, even I haven't done like a full-fledged user testing yet, because it's a work of user researchers, but be a part of it. Sit there and look at users using your application or whatever you have developed or anything. You'll realize that when you notice the behaviors, and probably, you know, there might be some learning. So it comes with experience or by doing things. So if you take part in a usability testing, or if you take part in any brainstorming session, you'll realize that the design that is proposed, or the way designer talks about, you know, users all the time, what is the, you know, background behind it? Why do they say that I attended this workshop where they said F-shaped pattern. So you would, so it's a pattern where, you know, kind of you place your articles on, you know, your buttons on a website in an F-shaped pattern, because they have done eye tracking studies. That's again a user testing. So they have done eye tracking studies and realized that these are the position where the users looks the most. So similarly, you'll understand those reasoning, and as developer, I know you're very logical, and you'll, you know, hit that logic, and you will like it, that it's not just some artsy stuff. They are not doing it just because they like it. They are coming from a, you know, solid background. They know what the research has been done on placing some elements. There are some times where designers go on board with their dreams and, you know, kind of things, but there are many things which are based on empirical data. That why do we have certain things? Why do we have clothes at the topmost corner? In HCI, it's a principle that all the corners are the most easily reachable points.
So how much is the role of intuition in design?
Some people have that knack of noticing people So when we say there are some good behavioral scientists who were not taught how to notice behaviors, or there were some psychologists who had the innate ability of, you know, understanding human psyche easily. So similarly in design, we have few people who are intuitive enough to understand this will become a good design. Sometimes it comes with experience. Yeah? It definitely develops over time. Yes. There's no shortcut. By intuition can come in play. Definitely. Until unless design is an iterative process, you never know what's going to work with the users unless you give it to them and ask them to fiddle with it. That's it. So if anyone, even in design, if someone asks, why do you think this is better than the one that I'm proposing? Because again, never use it as a, you know, kind of shield, because I've heard that you are not sure that this will work with the users. Why are you proposing this? See, we are coming from some data. We are using some of our, you know, creative energies to find, think that this might work. But help us, you know, take it out, test it with the users. If it doesn't work, then it will be fine. I've heard this statement from so many developers that why are you doing the user testing? To know what user thinks. But that's what you thought when you designed, right? You thought about the user and you designed it. And now are you testing with the same users? Are you not, you were not sure when you designed it? Like, no. Then, yeah, then you have a, you know, either you have a long discussion or a friendly banter on, you see, this is design is different from testing. And it's good to know, because let me tell you, in future or in, you know, in whatever you're trying to become, I know people are, you know, sometime in the future, if you want to be product owner or manager or product manager or like a feature owner, feature manager, wherever you want to have, you know, kind of an overview look on the product or the work that you do, you need to understand both design and development. It won't work without it. Anyway, I think we have, I mean, we had a really good chat. I got to know a lot of things. Not too many though, but I hope it was worthwhile for you guys too. Thanks.